Good afternoon, everyone. So today we are going to discuss the topic population interaction. First of all, I told you what is the meaning of population. Population means group of organisms that can interbreed. And they live in a particular geographical area. They live in the same geographical area. Okay, now if I'll talk about a natural habitat, you can take the example of any habitat. In that habitat, you will find that a single species never lives alone. There is a group of species. Okay, so obviously there is a group of population, so they will interact in one way or the another. So there is not even a single natural habitat where a single species is present. Okay, there are more than one species, and if there are more than one species, then obviously they are going to interact. So that what we have to study in this topic, that is population interaction. Now suppose if you think the example of a plant. A plant is there. You will say a plant can live alone. There is no need for it to have a species around it. Still you are wrong. Why? You know that a plant grows in the soil. And in the soil, various kinds of microbes are present. Those microbes are useful for the plant. Right? You know that these microbes, they use to convert the organic matter which is present in the soil. And then the inorganic nutrients are absorbed by the plant. So again, the plant is interacting with the microbes. So even if you think that plant is a herbivore, but still it is showing interaction. Am I clear? Any kind of organism, any kind of animal will feed on plant or any other kind of animal. So obviously, if a particular organism is feeding on a plant, then obviously in that area there must be two species, that organism and that plant, and the plant again interacting with the microbes. So that what I told you, in the natural habitat there is not even a single place where a single species is present. Okay, there is always a group. That is what our topic, population interaction. Clear? So basically in this chapter we have to study six types of population interaction. And this topic is quite important. First population interaction is predator. Second is parasitism. Sorry, it is predation. Parasitism, competition, mutualism. Commensalism. Now, one by one, let us talk about what is their meaning. Basically, as I told you, there will be an interaction. Okay, so suppose two species are there. Two species are interacting. How are they interacting? Whether they are getting, you can say, positive outcomes, or whether they are being harmed, that we have to study in this topic. Suppose if I talk about the predation, obviously two species are interacting, that is our topic, population interaction. So two species are interacting, suppose species A, and here I am writing species B. Now in predation, two species are interacting. One species is getting benefited while the other species is being harmed. Am I clear? Predation is a relation in which a predator feeds on the prey. In predation, there is a predator, and this predator will capture and eat the prey. Its best example is a lion eating a deer. Lion is a predator and deer is a prey. Lion eats deer, predator eats prey. So obviously predator is getting benefited. The predator is getting its food, energy, nourishment. While if I talk about the prey is losing his life. So a prey is getting harmed. Is it fine? So predation is a population interaction in which one species is getting benefited while the other is being getting harmed. So plus is for benefit. A species is getting benefit and B species it is getting harmed. Is it fine? Now let us talk about parasitism. About parasitism, you have studied in your earlier classes. Basically, parasitism, it is a kind of interaction in which again one species is getting benefited while the other is getting harmed. A lice on the human body. Simplest example, lice on the human body, on the human head basically. Lice is a parasite. It lives on the human head. It is taking the nourishment from the human head. It is taking the shelter. And at the same time, the human being is getting harmed because it sucks our blood. So lice is getting benefited. Lice is basically a parasite and we human are acting as its host. Is it fine? So parasites, it is a condition, it is an interaction in which a parasite lives on or in. Both conditions are possible. A parasite can live on the body of the host or in the body of the host. And they used to take their nourishment from the body of the host. So obviously a parasite is getting benefit. While if I talk about the host is being harmed. So in parasitism, species A is getting benefit and species B is getting harmed. Now you will think, what is the difference between a predation and parasitism? As you can see in both, A species is getting benefit and B species is being harmed. Then what is the difference? The difference you can just clearly see. In the predation, the predator was killing the prey. But in parasitism, the parasite is not killing the host. It is taking the nourishment from the host, no doubt. It is harming the host, no doubt. But it is not killing the host. Am I clear with this point? Now, there is one important point in the definition of parasitism. Parasitism is a kind of population interaction in which one species lives on or in the body of second species. These two species will be different. Why? Just let me give you one example. A human fetus lives in the womb of the mother. The fetus lives in the womb of the mother. Now some students will think, fetus is living in the body of the mother. Obviously the fetus is taking the nourishment of the from the body of the mother, so it is a parasite. But this is not so. Fetus is not a parasite. Why? Because these two are of the same species. Homo sapien, Homo sapien. Sapien basically this is the species. Okay, so a parasite belongs to a different species. Host belongs to a different species. Is it fine? No. So basically parasite takes food and shelter from the body of the host. Clear? No. Let us talk about next, competition. Both will be harmed. Suppose there is a species A, there is a species B. They are living in a habitat. They will be fighting for space, shelter, food. So what will happen in that case? Both will be getting harmed. Okay, species A will harm the species B in whatever manner that we have to discuss in detail. Okay, right now we are just talking about their definitions. And again, the species B is harming the species A. So what is happening in case of the competition? Both the species are getting harmed. Is it fine? Now, if I'll talk about the mutualism, it's a very good relationship basically. In mutualism, both the species are getting benefited, both. Okay, species A will also be benefited and species B will also be benefited. In mutualism, two species live together. Species A will benefit species B. Species B will benefit species A. And there is a condition. Species A will die if species B will not be there. एंड स्पीशीज बी साइमल्टेनियसली इट कैन नॉट लिव विदाउट स्पीशीज ए. इट मीन्स देयर रिलेशनशिप इज ऑब्लिगेटरी. ऑब्लिगेटरी मीन्स नेसेसरी फॉर देयर लाइफ. ओके, स्पीशीज ए एंड बी आर लिविंग टूगेदर, दे बोथ आर हेल्पिंग ईच अदर एंड दे कांट लिव विदाउट ईच अदर. इफ स्पीशीज ए इज नॉट देयर देन स्पीशीज बी विल ऑटोमेटिकली डाई. इज इट फाइन? नो. इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द कमेंसलिज्म, कमेंसलिज्म इज अ रिलेशनशिप इन विच वन ऑर्गेनिज्म इज गेटिंग बेनिफिटेड while the other organism is neither getting benefit nor harmed. Clear? Commensalism is a relationship in which one organism is getting benefit, two species are interacting, amongst that one species is getting benefit, other is neither getting benefit nor harmed, so neutral. And what happens in amensalism? One species is getting harmed and other species is not at all affected. Clear? So one by one we have to discuss all the population interaction in detail. So first of all let us talk about the topic predation. So now our topic is predation. Definition I told you, it is a kind of population interaction in which there is a predator that will capture, kill and eat the prey. Example again I told you, lion eats the deer. Clear? It's a kind of relationship in which one is getting benefit, that is the predator, and the second one is getting harmed. Okay. Now if I'll talk about the usefulness of the predation in the nature, is predation useful? Answer is yes. Why? All the population interactions are important. Okay. Why this predation is important for our ecosystem, for our environment. I'm not just talking about the lion. Obviously for the lion it is important. Lion is getting its food. But this predation, this population interaction is important for the ecosystem. Why? First, it helps in the transfer of energy. Okay. You know that trophic levels are there. Different organisms belong to different trophic level. Lion belongs to different trophic level. Deer belongs to different trophic level. This you know that, right? So basically, in predation, there is transfer of energy. The deer is being eaten by the lion. So the energy which is present in the body of the deer is being transferred to the lion. 10% law is there. Clear? So predation, it helps in the transfer of the energy in the ecosystem. Obviously in the ecosystem the energy has to be transferred. Clear? Second usefulness of the predation is that it maintains the number of organisms present in a particular area, or I can say it maintains population density. Okay? So predation maintains the population density. How? Let us talk about, just think, if lion will not be there, what will happen? The population of deer and the other organisms, that is the food of the tiger, it will enhance drastically. So it maintains the population density. So, there is an example in Australia. Prickly pear cactus, it was introduced. Okay, it was an exotic species. It was introduced from some another country. In Australia, prickly pear cactus was introduced. Now, what was the observation? Within very less amount of time, this cactus, it covers so much land. Why? Because its predator was not there. And if the predator will not be there, what will happen? The prey population will keep on increasing in size, increasing in number. That what I told you, if lion will not be there, what will happen? The number of deer will become enormously large. And as a result, the deer will start feeding on the grass. That will become low in number. So, predator maintain the population density. This prickly pear cactus, it was introduced in the Australia as it was exotic. So its predator was not there. Predator is always present where the prey is present. Because if prey is not there, the predator can't get its food. Obviously, predator will be present at that area only where prey is there, so that the predator can get its food. Is it fine? So now, this prickly pear cactus, it invades a massive land. So what the humans did, they brought a moth. This moth is its predator. Now the moth starts feeding on this cactus, and after a short interval of time, it was observed that now the cactus was spread in a less amount of area. Okay, so basically I can say predators maintain the number of the organisms. Third usefulness of the predation is predation maintains species diversity. How? Obviously, I told you in a particular place, in a habitat, there will be present many species. Okay, suppose there is a predator. You know about the food web. Like I am giving you the example of lion. It doesn't mean that lion will eat only deer. Lion eats so many different organisms. And in this way, it maintains the species diversity. If I'll remove the lion from the ecosystem, what will happen? All the remaining organisms, they will start competing. Either for food, either for shelter, for anything. They will start competing. And what will happen? The species diversity will lost. Its best example is piaster. In the American Pacific Coast, it was observed that there is a starfish named piaster. This starfish feeds on 10 different invertebrates. Okay, it feeds on 10 species, 10 different invertebrates. So when this starfish was removed, okay, then what happened? Out of those 10 species of invertebrates, 10 different species of invertebrates, many species got extinct. Why? Because those 10 species, they now start competing. Earlier they were not competing because of the starfish. Starfish used to eat them one by one. The starfish used to keep a check on their number. Now if the starfish is not there, their number increases. And the obviously out of those 10, one or two is going to dominate. So the rest species, they got vanished. So predation maintains the species diversity. Fourth point. Predators are prudent. Now, what is the meaning of prudent? It means they have a future for the they have a thought for the future. They are intelligent. How? Suppose lion is there. If, just think, what will happen if the lion will eat all the deer that are present in that forest in a single day? On the second day, the lion will not get its food. Okay, fine, you'll talk about the food web. No problem. But what will happen if the lion will eat all the prey within a week, within a month? Then after that, will the lion get its food? No. So predators, they are prudent. They eat according to their hunger. They don't store their food. Okay. Suppose a lion is feeding on a deer and it is able to fulfill its requirement with that one deer for 3 days. Then for those 3 days, it is not going to kill and eat any other organism. Am I clear? So they are prudent. They think for the future also. If with the help of a particular organism, they are getting fulfilled for 1 week, then for 1 week, they are not going to eat any other kind of the organism. Clear? Now, so these are the four things that you should know about the predator. They maintain the species diversity. They help in the transfer of the energy in the trophic level. They are prudent in nature. They think for the future. And they eat according to their hunger. And the last one is, they maintain the number of the species in a particular area. Now, let us... Now obviously the prey, as I told you, predator is eating the prey. Now the prey must got some adaptations to protect itself from the predator. It's a common thing. Obviously, a lion is eating a deer. Lion can eat a deer. A deer must possess a few adaptations. With the help of that, the deer can save itself from the lion if possible. So now we have to talk about the different adaptations that are present in the prey so as to protect itself from the predator. So now let us talk about the adaptations. Okay, firstly I am talking about the adaptations in the animals. First adaptation is camouflage. About this you are very much familiar. There are a few insects, frog, they used to blend their color with the environment. Now just think, what will happen if they will blend their color with the environment? Now the predator is not able to see them. And if the predator will not be able to see them, the predator will not eat them. As simple as that. So clear? A few animals like insects, frog, they show the property of the camouflage. They can blend their color. They can blend the color of their body with the surrounding environment. They can change their color. Clear? Second is, some animals, they are very distasteful. And obviously, if they will not be good in taste, a predator is not going to eat them. Its example is monarch butterfly. Okay, organisms, they used to secrete some harmful chemical also. Monarch butterfly. Okay, organisms, they used to secrete poisonous chemicals also. Some organisms produce offensive smell. With the help of these kind of the adaptations, they avoid the predator. Okay. Now if I'll talk about a plant. Plants are being eaten by the organisms. We used to call them as herbivore, but they are not less than a predator. A plant is being eaten by any other animal. So that animal, basically that animal is the predator. So a plant wants to save itself from that predator. So a plant must be having a few adaptations. Like its example is thorns. Spines in case of the cactus or puncia. They protect the plant from the predator. Is it fine? Some plants they use to produce the harmful chemicals. And if any animal will eat that plant, then these harmful chemicals will enter in the body of the animal and then they will harm that animal. Clear? They can harm the reproductive system of that animal. They can harm the digestive system of that animal. Now, so what are the adaptations in the plants? They could have thorns. They produce the harmful chemicals. Even the substances that we use like nicotine, opium, that we obtain from the plants as a drug. These are basically produced by the plant as a defense mechanism to protect itself from the predator. Clear? So today we have discussed about the population interaction and the predation. The rest population interaction we will discuss in the subsequent classes. Thank you.